As many of you are aware, might be aware, I design logos for companies. I select company names and also design logo for the company based on some Vedic system. Okay, and many of my friends keep on asking me, what is this Vedic logo designing is about? And how did you enter into this Vedic logo designing? What is this Vedic principles applying to logos, designing up logos and all? And how did, see, so far I have designed logos and selected company names, designed logos for more than 5,000 companies across the world. And when all of them are running very well today by the grace of God. So some of them ask me, what is the principle behind this Vedic logo system? What is the system and all? And how did I come into this line basically? Basically, I'm an engineer. I did my M.Tech in electrical engineering. And I was working in an engineering college. So around 93, one day, one of my friends who has an running an industry of his own has come to our house and met me. And while having some general discussion, he was telling me he was not doing so well in his industry, in spite of his best efforts. So he has got very good technical people with him, financial strength, and his designs, his production team, his industry. I mean, everything is very well. He is doing very well. He is giving the best efforts, but still he is not successful. So I was, he was quite worried about that. So I was also a little worried why, in spite of all his best efforts, he was not doing so well in the industry. So around that time, I also understood some companies, some people, they have done exceptionally well in 3 to 4 areas. And then when they want to diversify in some new area, they lose all the money what they have earned in this 4 or 5 industry areas. Okay, and why is that? In spite of their best efforts, with so much strength and so much of experience, years of experience behind them, why is that they are not successful in the new area? Sometimes they are the mightiest people in the industry also, but still they have left that industry, that new line, telling that it doesn't suit us. Similarly, sometimes we see a joint venture, a talks between two companies will go to almost to the final extent, and finally the talks break down at that. Without much reason and logic behind it. So normally we hear, no, we hear people like that, and sometimes, no, a good venture starts in a big way, and in the last 3 to 4 years, it gets on longer and longer, delays in the project and all. Sometimes you send some pharma to some export, and finally the thing gets rejected there, and you can't even get it back because that will be more losses to you. Okay, so these things we see with many industries around us. Okay, so then why is it that? Then I just thought, is there any relationship between our date of birth, based on our Vedic system, to the line of business we do, and the company name we put, and the logo we put? And see, normally the company name, we select a company name with our own concept and liking, we pick up a name and all. Is it that for some people, for some company line, they doesn't suit them? Or is it because some colors in the logo, are they not very favorable to the promoters? Is it that they are blocking the growth of the companies? Is it that they have got an effect, the geometrical pattern of the logo has an effect? Is it, so I just, around 2 to 3 years, about around 93, I took many companies and their promoters, their birth details, and just correlated with the industries they are doing, the company name, what the name put, what is the name, and what is the brand name, what is the logo, and what are the geometric patterns into the logo, and all. Then I found out some very interesting observations after end of my study. Then I just thought, logo is not just another graphic design. it can make or break a company altogether. If the colors in the logo doesn't suit the promoters, okay, and some whatever efforts they put and all, there will be some problem, some in the growth of the companies. Similarly, name also, the sounding of the name is very important actually. See, that is the reason we see some of the best. It may not have the meaning also, in a company name may not have a meaning also, but if the sounding of the word is very prosperous for the promoter, then it gives a lot of profits to the promoter, the company. The company grows very well. We see some of the Western companies, if you see, they doesn't have any meaning in the sense. Even our Indian companies also, they take some alphabets together and form a word, and then they coin a word. It looks nice for them. And suppose if the word has got a positive vibration for the promoters, then it gives a lot of prosperity to the promoter, lot of profits to the promoter. The company will grow very well. So how do I arrive at all these factors? What is that things that are there in our Vedas? See, Vedas have got enormous knowledge for all fields, either medicine or engineering or literature or biological sciences or space science and everything. Many sciences have got tremendous lot of knowledge in the Vedas. So if we could pick up some things from that, to which can be applied to our business organizations, so the companies would prosper very well. So, mentioning you, I found out some very interesting patterns, interesting observations in our Vedic principles, which I would share with you a couple of things now. So, how do I design a Vedic logo if someone comes to me for the logo designing? So suppose someone asks me for the logo designing, or he needs a company name for the company, then I take his birth details. Suppose if there are 3-4 people in the company, then I take birth details of all the 3-4 of them and study what are the planets that give them a lot of prosperity for their growth and all. And then each planet actually in our Vedic system, each planet corresponds to a geometric curves also. Many of us are aware that each planet corresponds to a particular stone. Some of us wear rings like sapphire or like that. Okay, and similarly, in our Vedas, it is clearly mentioned each planet has got a corresponding geometrical curve also in our Vedas. So I take these geometrical curves which are favorable to the promoter. Suppose there are 3 people in the organization. For somebody, Jupiter is giving a lot of prosperity throughout his life. Okay, so I take what is the curve that corresponds to Jupiter. See, suppose it could be like this. The curve corresponding to Jupiter could be like this. And then, so another promoter, for him, maybe the Saturn is giving. And so I think what is the curve corresponds to Saturn. Okay, and similarly, some other promoter, it could be Venus. So what is the curve corresponds to Venus, that I'll take. Okay, and suppose there are some common planets also, like Sun is giving a lot of prosperity for them. So I take some line that corresponds to the curve that corresponds to the particular pattern, sun into and separate. I just arrive at these different lines. Similarly, and apart from this, if a company has to grow to very well, it should be one of the best known areas in its line of business, we can put one line into the logo like this. Some line you can put, a line correspond. You put that line in the logo, it goes to a very high level of growth. Similarly, and apart from the name and all, it should have good financial strength also for the company, isn't it? So for financial strength, I'll put one more line. And finally, loyal manpower. If any group, any organization, if it has to come up, you need loyal people to work with for several years. Many of the industry groups, if we just look around us, there are people in their key positions who have worked with 25 to 30 years with them. and they are the pillars of the organization. So retain good people, you can put one line in the logo. Okay, and similarly, the company should not have any legal problems also. Okay, everything should go smoothly. For that also, to avoid legal problems, you can put one line in the logo. And I cannot just say, put all these logos and say this is the logo, isn't it? Logo has to be, it should be some meaningful design. So what I'll do, I'll just bring together all these lines in some meaningful pattern, some like some flower, and in a meaningful pattern. And then see the curve in this pattern itself, all these curves are hidden into the logo. Okay, these are all these, they have got all these planetary curves which correspond to the growth of the companies. We have hidden into the logo. Then the logo works wonders for the companies. Similarly, I'll just show you one logo now. Yeah, see this logo. Just one more logo I'll show you. Yeah, see this logo. Yeah, this is as you can see. Okay, this is designed in blue color. It is a horse. It's some rights company. Okay, so I've taken the. See, even though it has got, what are the things it has got? It has got a horse here, and it is an elliptical, and you've got sun rays here. Okay. But actually, these are all, they all corresponds to the planetary curves of the promoters, and what I was just explaining to you, the growth curves, and we have incorporated this. If you just split them separately, all these curves are. Only those curves are hidden into this. See, this horse could be. When symbolized in many ways, art could be done symbolized in many ways. So why I took this way is because these curves are the curves which are there, which are corresponds to those planetary symbols, the planets. Similarly, these curves angles and these angles also, they all corresponds to the primary curves of the promoters and the growth curves for the company. Bring together in a meaningful form. Then once you start using this logo, it gives wonders for the companies. And the colors also, see, for someone actually, green color be good, could be good, for could give prosperity, for some orange could be give lot of prosperity, for some of you blue could be giving lot of prosperity. So I'll see which are the cows that are giving lot of prosperity and which are the colors that give lot of prosperity to the promoters, key people. Then I just include those colors into the logo. So similarly, you can see another logo here. This logo has got different three colors. Okay, blue, deep yellow, and orange. So even though it is looking like V, it is simply V. But the thing is, this is a slanted line. This line, I just used it here. This line corresponds to a planet which gives lot of growth for the promoter of this company. Similarly, this curve also. This line, another slanted line to this particular angle. This gives lot of prosperity to the promoter. So I have just put this line here, put this line here, and there are two curves which are required for him. So those curves I brought them together here, and with use that color, particular color which is good for them. And then a semicircular like color curve is very important for the promoter. So I have just put it semicircle here in a particular angle to some extent, extended it more little, okay, because it's required to that angle. So then bringing it together, this is the whole palm, is the logo for the company. Okay. Now it looks elegant and nice, but it has got hidden planetary curves into the logo itself, which give prosperity to the promoters. If we use such logos, they grow very well. They grow very well. And because see, human brains attract graphic symbols more than alphabets. The moment you see a company name, think of any company name, immediately the logo comes to your mind. Because we store easily those geometrical patterns. So if we can put some power into the logo, okay, then the companies would go very well. It will give a lot of growth and prosperity to the promoter. See, among colors also, blue has got, human brain has got a liking for blue color. See, most of world's, almost 80% of the world's logos if you observe it, they'll be in blue color. At least a part of it will be in blue color, like State Bank Group, IBM, or Intel, or Microsoft. You think of many major companies, they are right in blue color. Because blue is associated with finance function, actually. In our Vedas, blue is clearly, it corresponds to Aishwarya, the prosperity of the company. So many companies, somehow they put blue color into the company. And human brain has got a serene effect on looking at blue color. It gives a lot of prosperity for the company. So, and apart from that, I also incorporate which are the good colors that are important, that give a lot of prosperity to the promoter. We put these colors into the logo. And selecting company name also, I see each planet, they correspond to a particular sound also, okay? Because see, always, it's only the word, when you pronounce in a particular way, the vibration, what vibration gets. So that is more important for the growth of that is the power, the word has got power, isn't it? We always hear about this in our Vedas also. Word, any word, these are all our mantras, everything. When you pronounce a word, a vibration will comes out. That vibration, these vibrations give a lot of, some of the vibrations are very prosperous for us. Okay, so some of the brands, if you see, it is for this reason, sometimes some brands become very popular even if they doesn't have any meaning. Because when you pronounce that word of the brand, the vibration that comes with the word, it gives a lot of prosperity to the promoters. And human brain has liking for certain sounds also. See, suppose when you watch TV, okay, you hear about a new brand. Okay, immediately, the moment you see the brand and hear about that name of the brand, you develop a liking and you would like to buy tomorrow itself. Okay, you feel it's going to be of good quality, you must buy this brand. See, quality is, how can you define quality? See, once you start using it, you will know about the quality, okay? But human brain associates quality with some sound, actually. Sound of a word, some sound of words, and some color patterns, and geometrical patterns, colors and all. So the moment it hears that word, that sound, immediately it associates quality with that, and you feel like buying, it's going to be of good quality, it's going to be very tasteful, okay? Like, it associates that with that. So if you select a company name or a brand name on these principles of which sounds are good for the, easily remembered by us in general, in a consumer base, like we are all human beings, okay? So for us, which sounds are good, many of the times the company names, they are put by either their family names, or they just add together some alphabets of their children, or then some known places, or they some god of their faith, belief. Okay, they then add together and they bring out a form. So, and it need not necessarily have a meaning also. Many, okay, what I am telling to drive is the sounding of the word should be very prosperous for the promoter. Based on his planet, suppose someone comes to me for a company name to be given to him, okay, and I'll just analyze his birth chart and see which are the planets that are giving him a lot of prosperity. And among 9 planets, normally 2 to 3 planets will govern our life all throughout us. They are the protectors for us. They take care of us. So I'll just arrive at which are these three planets and see what are the corresponding sounds for this each planet. And with those sound to coming together, I'll form a word and give it to them as a name, company name, a brand name. Similarly, I'll see the corresponding curse for each planet. Bringing them together, we form a logo. And what are the colors with that colors we put into that. So then the companies will grow very well. The name, the brands also will come up very well. And they run very profitably in the for several years. See, I have seen actually sometimes one big industry group has come to me with a problem, but that they're doing some negotiations for a big project. Everything is going on very well, but it is dragging for years and years. They're unable to somehow come at a final understanding, okay, when an agreement. So then I just saw their visiting card and the logo of the company, and I just immediately observed, I took the date of birth of the promoters, and immediately I just observed there is one curve in the logo which is detrimental to them, okay, which is holding back everything for them, which is most unfavorable curve for the promoters, which doesn't, it is acting as a hurdle for the promoter. So I have not changed much of the logo. I just took off that curve. I told them just remove this curve and see. So within a week, immediately they have removed that curve, and again with the new logo, after removing the curve in that logo, with the new logo, they have sent another proposal to the, another letter they just sent to the other party. Within just 15 to 20 days, the agreement was done. The project went off very well and immediately. Everything went smoothly. So they were so much surprised, in fact. And then I addressed also an industry body in Hyderabad regarding Vedic applications, because there were many of the industry people at that time, they were quite surprised. A small car, I mean, could hold back everything for so much time. Okay, so that's how sometimes a small, simple car can make a call line here and there, can make or break a company. That's what I tell. A logo can make or break a company. Sometimes a small curve here and there, if it is detrimental for years, the companies won't, they struggle. And many of us have got another one doubt. See, what if we have got a company already and we cannot change the name of the company because financial issues are involved and we cannot change now. In fact, that is, and we want to prosper very well. Okay. In fact, many organizations for whom I designed logos are all existing companies only. Okay, but they were having some problem and they came to me. By the time they come to me, the companies are limited, companies, financial issues are involved. Okay, so at that time, what we can do, we need not change the company name, we just keep the name as it is. Okay, and design a new logo for the company by incorporating all these planetary Vedic principles, planetary curves and all. Once you use this new logo for the company, immediately the company will come into prosperity. It will grow very well. You can just keep the name as it is. See, I've done for one, designed a company about 20 years ago like this. The company was doing very bad. It's almost going to the stage of closing. It's a major unit in Andhra Pradesh, and it was almost going to be closed. So, okay, they were in a very bad shape. So, some employee in a bank is one of the, they've got a consortium of bankers for that industry. One employee just told about me. He heard about me through in press somewhere. So, he told them. So, they came to know, and they came and met me actually. So, when I saw, they told us, sir, we cannot change the name of the company. There is already financial issues are involved in this. Okay, then I redesigned the logo. Okay, I just see logo can always be redesigned. They've just redesigned the logo. I took that when I just saw the profile of the date of birth of the promoters, the name doesn't suit them at all actually. Absolutely, the sounding of the word of the company name doesn't go well with the promoters' birth profiles. Okay, their planets and that, it's completely opposite to that. It gives an opposite bearing. But they just named it several years ago like that. Okay, they cannot change it now. So then we have redesigned the logo. I told them, and immediately they have started using it. Within a month, a new investor has come. Actually, he just appeared from nowhere like that. He just came to know through someone, and then he came to know, and he has invested in the company, and the company immediately within 6 months it grew very well. So much so, when a company grows like that, apart from the promoters, the banker also will be very happy, isn't it? So the CGM of the bank and their GMs, all of them have came to my house and met me. One evening they came and met me, and they said, sir, what is this? We have pumped crores into this company and nothing has moved, but you just gave a logo. with just few thousands of rupees. And how is this? Miracles have happened. We just saw within 4 months how the company has come up very well again. So why didn't you kindly address us? They said. So I just told them, sir, it's simple Vedic principles. It is nothing of nothing great of me. See, our Vedas have got such enormous knowledge. So I have addressed a professional body in Hyderabad about how these Vedic principles have applied for this company and for some other companies, how I design a logo. Simple. There are wonderful principles in our Vedas which can be applied to any every field of our day-to-day life. Okay, so medicine or engineering or literature or sociology, geography, pain sciences, for all sciences, Vedas have got great knowledge in them. Greatest knowledge. So I took some of it. I did lot of research for. See, one lifetime is not enough to study these sciences, Vedic sciences. So I just took a small part, and for organizations, business organizations, or any it could be any organization, how an organization could be made prosperous. I studied for about 2-3 years, and then found out some very interesting observations. See how these planets, and each colors have also has got a corresponding mantra associated with a color also. Many of the people are not aware of it. Okay. So if you put that color patterns and all into the logos, the companies do very well. That is how I have been designing logos for the last 25 years, and till now I have designed for more than 6,000 companies worldwide. They are almost every city of India has got at least few companies designed by me, and I am very happy that all of them are running very well. And several countries like USA, UK, Canada, Australia, Philippines, many places, many countries, Japan also. I didn't design for some companies there, and many countries they are doing extremely well. France I did for some company, in Switzerland I did for a company, in Paris I did for a for an organization related to fashion industry I did. They are doing extremely well. And in Africa I did for some companies. They are into agriculture and all, and some mining. They are doing very well today. In fact, they are one of the best companies there. Okay. Another beautiful thing is, see, it could be applied to any religion. Okay. Many. I have done for people with all religions and all faiths across the globe. You see, finally, everyone wants prosperity, isn't it? I have done for Americans, British, Canadian nationals, French nationals, African nationals, and many Philippines nationals. All everybody. And our Indian, Sri Lankans also, I did some couple of companies, and all of them. See, finally, we want prosperity. We want to grow well. You grow well and give something back to the society, isn't it? You want to grow very well, and once you grow well, hundreds of people would get employment with you, and the blessings would come back to you and to your families, and to my family as well, isn't it? So that is my field. See, I always treat whoever comes to me for advice as God himself. Okay, I have never attached a price tag for anyone. Okay, I've designed logo for a small medical hall across the street, and I've designed logo for some companies of one of the biggest corporate hospital healthcare groups in India. Okay, for them both are same for me. And I've done for a very small automobile spares dealer who already gets a couple of thousands a day. Okay, I did logo for him, and I've also designed for one of the best automobile dealers in India, okay, South India or India. For me, both are same. Okay, absolutely, I treat them both as equal, as God himself for both. Okay, because see, prosperity, well-being is same to everyone. Happiness is same to everyone. You should be happy finally at the end of the day. I always, whenever I design a logo, I work with meditation. That is the reason I cannot give. I tell them people, frankly, I can't give in overnight. If you want tomorrow morning, I can't give a logo like that. You go to ad agency and get it done. Okay, because I need absolute serenity. That is the reason I take sometimes week, 10 days. There are times when I took even 2 months for a logo. Okay, But at the end of the day, they are very happy. Fortunately, no one pressurizes me. No one tells me, sir, you just give whenever you feel like doing it. Because you need to do it in a serene way. See, when you are very serene, the planetary curves would just flow back. They flow in front of me simply. What are the curves that are prosperous for this promoter? They just simply flow in front of my eyes. Though I just pick up those curves and put it into the logo. Okay, that's how companies see. I design the logos, and that's how. And these people are doing extremely well. I've done for several companies in Chennai, Bangalore, and all whom I've not seen also. There are people for whom I've designed for maybe more than 10 to 12 companies in the last 10, 15 years, but I haven't met them yet. Then I'm very happy, but they're doing extremely well and giving back to the society. So I wish you all a great success in every sphere of your life. I hope all of you lead a wonderful, healthy and happy and prosperous life. With the same simple basic principles, we can have wonderful company names, do very well company logos, and do very well in our businesses, make good profits and diversify into other areas, grow very well, okay, and finally give back something back to the society. Okay, I wish you all the best. I pray Lord Srinivasa to bless you all. I pray Lord Srinivasa to bless you all with great prosperity in all fields of life, your families and your children, your relatives, friends, employees in your organizations. Okay, Sarve Jana Sukhino Bhavantu.